the surprising ways Earth could survive an asteroid strike. It's widely held that it was an asteroid that doomed the dinosaurs, a hurtling hunk of space rock that, around 66 million years ago, crashed into Earth and rewrote the ecosystems of an entire planet. Today, an asteroid impact is still something we, to some extent, plan for, but what says that we would fare any better than the dinosaurs did? This is Unveiled, and today we're uncovering the extraordinary ways that Earth could survive an asteroid strike. Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more fascinating content. Asteroid strikes actually already occur with surprising frequency. The size of the asteroid is what determines how much damage it can do, with smaller impacts sometimes passing by unnoticed. But asteroids big enough to strike Earth with the force of a hydrogen bomb reportedly happen every couple hundred years or so. One of the last events of this kind was in Siberia in 1908, where there were thankfully less people directly affected. But swap the remoteness of Siberia for a city housing millions, and it's clear there's the potential for catastrophe. It's thought that a city could fall to an asteroid that's around 100 meters across. Meanwhile, a 1 kilometer rock could pack enough force to destroy a wider region, perhaps a mid-sized country, and a 10 kilometer asteroid could cause planet-wide devastation. It's proposed that the KT mass extinction that killed the dinosaurs, triggering the rise of the mammals, was caused by an asteroid 10 to 15 kilometers wide. Today we have the Torino Impact Hazard Scale to quantify potential Earth impact risks on a scale of 1 to 10. It says that events scoring 10 on the scale occur once every 100,000 years. So are we in any imminent danger of being hit by a 10 right now? Well, no, but there have been various scares, like in 2002 when we sighted an asteroid which was deemed to have a chance of colliding with Earth in 2019. It would have been big enough to cause a major disaster, but luckily it missed. And while we do have astronomers all around the world scanning the skies for threats, there have also been some that we've missed. Like in 2013, when the Chelyabinsk meteor crashed into Russia, sending out a shockwave that shattered windows and injured around 1,500 people. No one saw that coming, once again proving how dangerous asteroids can be, and how vulnerable Earth can suddenly become. But there's no need to overly worry, because we do spot most of them. And NASA even has an impact risk page on its website where you can check to see the status of the asteroids currently being monitored. One of the top impact risks listed right now is the asteroid Bennu, which it's predicted could potentially strike in around 2175. But say a big one slipped through the net, say an Earth-ending rock was suddenly spotted at close approach to our planet, how could we survive it? We can't outright stop an asteroid because they're traveling too fast, clocking speeds up to 55,000 miles per hour. But we can try to alter its trajectory, with just a tiny nudge being enough to drastically change its path. How do we do that? One way is with vehicles known as gravity tractors. Gravity tractors are massive, sprawling machines which work by inflicting on the oncoming asteroid a gravitational influence of their own. Over years or even decades, this influence is enough to push the asteroid toward a different, non-Earthbound course. It's a method of deflecting the rock without actually touching it. The only downside is that gravity tractors are totally theoretical right now. A great idea, but if we learned of a near-future impact tomorrow, they probably wouldn't be a lot of help. Another, perhaps less impressive, but arguably more doable approach would be to slow the asteroid down. In this way, we wouldn't be altering the space rock's course, but were we to slow it sufficiently, it could miss Earth anyway, because we'd be at a different place in our orbit by the time it arrived at a slightly later point. In this case, we'd more simply need something, another massive remote-controlled spaceship perhaps, to crash into it, hopefully causing the rock to falter. Even better, we could try bombarding one side of the asteroid with multiple ships, all at the same time. On the plus side, it could work. On the downside, it could be dangerous, it definitely would be expensive, and, well, it might not work. But there might be other ways of slowing it down without destroying billions of dollars worth of our own equipment. We could try firing paintballs at it. Yep, this really is one proposed way of stopping an asteroid. Put forward in 2012 by MIT's Department of Aeronautics and astronautics graduate Sungwoon Paik, the plan is that by pelting the rock with white paint, which crucially reflects the most light, we could, theoretically, cause it to experience more solar radiation pressure, which is a force exerted by the photons given out by the sun. It perhaps sounds far-fetched, but we have already seen satellites of our own being pushed ever so slightly by this phenomenon over long periods of time. Therein lies the downside, though, because it's estimated that paintballing an asteroid away from us would take around 20 years to achieve. It's more feasible than some of the other options, but only if we have the time to make it work. So we've tried diverting it, slamming into it, and painting it. Next, we'll remove some of its mass. In theory, if we could chisel enough of an asteroid's surface mass away, we could again change its trajectory. And for fans of this method, the instrument of choice is almost always a laser. Were we to build a laser strong enough to heat the rock so that parts of it began to dissolve, then the escaping gas could work against it in space, acting like a thruster to edge it toward a different destination. It's a technique officially called asteroid laser ablation, and it's an idea which is already genuinely being considered by the likes of NASA. Of all the asteroid averting proposals, this one is arguably the most likely to actually get developed. But if gravity tractors, paint guns, and even lasers don't work, what then? Desperate times really would call for desperate measures, in the shape of atom bombs. Here's where the world's space agencies would need to tap into their inner Bruce Willis, with suggestions that we really could blast an asteroid out of the sky, though not quite as they do in the movies. One idea says that if we could detonate a large enough bomb close enough to an asteroid, we could both burn off some of its mass and alter its path in one explosive move. It's easily one of the more unpredictable methods, however, with one particularly glaring downside being the possibility that we'd be transforming the asteroid into one massive shotgun blast, shooting dozens of smaller but still lethal bits of rock toward Earth, striking various locations that might have even been safe otherwise. It's lucky, then, that there are more than a few options to try out beforehand. Were we ever to discover an asteroid heading straight for our planet, it'd represent arguably the biggest technological challenge humanity had ever faced to try and in some way avoid impact. We do have at least some ideas on what we'd try to do next, but those are the surprising ways Earth could survive an asteroid strike. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.